everyone, welcome back. It's Moa, aka Swedish Whiskey Girl, and today we're going to have a look at a single grain whiskey called Spearhead. So this is from the Loch Lomond Distillery. It is quite an interesting one, and one that makes it a little bit difficult to explain what single grain whiskey is. So this is made from 100% malted barley, but normally single grain whiskey is made from other grain types like corn or wheat. But this is made from 100% malted barley, and the thing that makes it a single grain whiskey and not a single malt whiskey is that it's been distilled in coffee stills, and they have a different type of distillation. You can distill it much higher. It's like you're distilling it over and over and over again to get it quite high. So it usually has a much lighter style than a single malt, which is double distilled. But this is technically distilled once, but because distill is kind of distilling, 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 you can bring it up much higher to over 90%. And this is also bottled at 43%. They're kind of marketing as you can drink this neat or you can have it in cocktails, and I think it retails at £30. They also have a thing that I have not heard about before, because I think these are the Loch Lomond is the first distillery to do this in Scotland so far. It's infrared toasted barrels. So they've used both traditionally toasted and infrared toasted barrels. Not sure exactly what it does to the cask that's different, but I think it's the infrared toasting makes it easier to control the temperature and the level of what you're toasting your barrels to be. It's like I said, made from 100% malted barley and matured in ex-bourbon barrels, finished in a combination of those infrared and fire-toasted virgin American oak barrels. So yeah, I mean, if you watched the channel before, you know that I love a grain whiskey. I think they can be really interesting, and if you have a sweet tooth and like a bit of a desserty whiskey, then these can be great. So I'm excited to try these, because one of my favourite grain whiskies is the Loch Lomond single grain, and I'm guessing this should be quite similar. But let's have a look on the nose. Straight away you get this kind of, I think it's often like vanilla ice cream, the single grain sweetness. A little bit of the wood coming through. It almost has a touch that reminds me of a bourbon, so it's probably that virgin American oak that brings an intensity that I don't think you get often from ex-bourbon casks. And it's also quite grassy. I would say it's almost, for me today, a little bit more grassy than sweet on the nose, like that kind of freshly cut grass. It doesn't have too many layers, but it is quite interesting because of what's in the glass are quite... It might just be because I'm used to nosing single malts more than I'm used to nosing single grain, which makes the single grain seem a little bit different. And it's... Because those aromas are slightly different, it makes them interesting to kind of delve deeper into, even though they are not necessarily a lot of them. I'm kind of getting those kind of three main things, and they are the ones that I'm kind of focusing on. But let's have a little taste. Slangeva. Yeah, and the palate's quite grassy as well. Grassy, a little bit woody. I would probably say this is a little bit more robust than other single grains that I've tried. Just because it's not the main thing in it that I'm getting isn't that kind of vanilla ice cream sweetness. It's there, but it's kind of underneath the other tones. I'm getting a little bit more of a stone fruitiness on the nose as well. And almost blended in with a little bit of pine, so I wonder if the wood grassiness on the palate transfers onto the palate. What did I just say? Onto the nose. Because sometimes I think when you've tasted a whiskey, and if it's different or enhancing or contrasting to what you're getting on the nose, it can then bring out other things on the nose that you didn't get first. So it's almost like your palate is suggesting notes that you didn't find at the first kind of nose of it, and then that brings them out a little bit more. So I wonder if that wood and the grassiness combine and brings out a bit of pine. Almost a bit of brown sugar as well. Yeah, I think it has a touch. I think what makes it a little bit more robust is that it has this edge that might be a little bit towards like a neutral green spirit note, which makes it a little bit more. I'm trying to figure out, this is why it takes me a while to say these sentences. I can just hear myself talking really, really slowly because I'm trying to figure out what I'm actually trying to say whilst I'm saying it. So what I'm thinking is, I wonder if this neutral grain spirit note at the edges, to me it makes it feel more robust, but I wonder to some people it might make it feel a little bit younger. I mean, it's not non-age statement, so I would guess that it could be a little bit of younger spirit in this. And I think, this is the thing, so I think what makes that neutral grain spirit note might seem a little bit robust to me, but that robustness might make this grain spirit a better introduction to grain spirit for someone who is a single malt drinker if they don't perceive that as a young note. I don't mind drinking young whiskey, but if you're used to drinking whiskeys that are 12 years and above, you might get that youngness as the primer thing. Does this make sense at all? I think it's just a way of perceiving flavors, because some people I know don't like grain whiskey. It could be because you have a preconception of what grain whiskey is, but it could also be because it doesn't have the weight of malt whiskeys often. It is usually lighter, it's usually sweeter. I wouldn't say this is super sweet, which is why I think it might be a good one if you are a single malt drinker who wants to try grain whiskey. But I also think it could be that you just think it tastes a bit young as well. Especially with the grassy notes, because grassiness could be something that I would find in a new mixed spirit or something that's quite young. And compared to the Loch Lomond grain, I haven't made a comparison and I haven't tried Loch Lomond grain in a while, but from a memory of it, it's super tropical. I need to try them. Try it again sometime and see how these compare. But it's quite light still. But yeah, to me it's just a little bit more robust. If you've tried a grain whiskey, you might understand what I mean, because grain whiskeys tend to be quite not so offensive in a way. I mean, I love grain whiskey, I think they're fun. But I'd love to hear your thoughts. Have you tried Spearhead, or have you tried the Loch Lomond Grain Whiskey? I'd love to hear your tasting notes and what you thought of it. And of course, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, I'd be so excited if you would consider leaving a thumbs up and maybe subscribe if you haven't already. Or of course, if you do want to support the channel further, I've included my affiliate links to Master Malt, the Whiskey Exchange, and the Scotch Malt Whiskey Society here below. And as always, I want to say a massive thank you to my wonderful supporters on Patreon. I'm so grateful to have you with me on my whiskey journey. I'll see you in the next one. Sláinte, Scoil.